Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, I'm Stony VR, and today I show you San Andreas in virtuality in first person with Warp X. Maybe I can change your mind now about Warp X, and San Andreas works better than the most games with Warp X. The first person mod is excellent, and in combination with head track positioning, it works flawless. For me, especially the 3D area, GTAs are for me the best Warp X experience that I got. Since I play with Dolphin VR and since I play the GTA 5 VR mod, it changed completely my mind. I was always a guy that say motion controllers and virtuality headset goes hand in hand. Sometimes I was thinking motion controllers are more important than the headset themselves. But we are gamer, we play comfortable, we are used to play lazy, right? And San Andreas is a so good game, you get immersed and have fun, and that's why I can just recommend it. It works so well with Warp X because of the real 3D body cam. You just see a weapon when you aim, and the first person mod makes it perfect. Yeah? They make a so good job with the first person mod. There are also some problems. Some missions are not working in first person, so when you enter a mission in first person, some missions are crashed. Yeah, these are really known problems. You can Google, but it's just a few missions and you have just to switch to third person before you start the mission. So when you're not able to make a custom resolution, you will play like in DK1. Yeah? You need really a 4K, 2K or even higher resolution. But this resolution that I recommended is already perfect. It's like playing a native VR game from the graphic. The graphic is like playing how you are used to it, virtuality games, when you use this resolution. I promise you. And you can turn it even higher with anti-aliasing because of the silent patcher that is included in the mod pack that I prepared for you. And yeah. There's also a lightning mod included. See the lights more on distance. My San Andreas videos looks really magically. It's because of this lightning mod. And you will see it in VR when you see the sunsets and colors and the charm, the nostalgic kick, the music, the radio, the characters. Everything fits together and it gives you a wonderful Warp X experience. When you download my mod pack that I prepared for you, the radar is a bit smaller than here in the video. I make it a little bit smaller. You see also sometimes black bars here in the video, but this is just because of my Oculus Mirror. It was not correct set. You can also use the Warp X controller option to play touch controller as gamepad. You can use the Warp X in-game option for this to bind your motion controller with keyboard keys or gamepad keys, and it's also pretty good. There's also a shift key. Warp X inspired me to do the same with X pedal, but I get rather better results because I have hidden holding bind, double bindings and a shift button for a completely new layout. Yeah, and thanks to all the modders and patchers, I appreciate it. Without all those mods, it would not be possible. Without the first person mod, without the HUD mod. You can usually change the HUD with Warp X when you have the Geometry 3D option, but this works not in all games. And unfortunately, it works not in 3D area GTAs. You can't adjust your HUD with Warp X. That's why I use in San Andreas the HUD interface. And you can change the HUD when you want. There's a start file in the main folder. This is a Russian software that allows you to change the HUD. So this editor works not well because the resolution is so high. So it's really a bit try and error. I recommend it not to change much. You will see, you will find it out. Try it by yourself, you will see what I'm meaning. It's happened because the resolution is too high for this HUD editor. So let's start. This is the Steam build. Just press on San Andreas, right click, press on Properties, browse location, and you found your main folder. Copy the downgrader into the main folder, and one at as admin. And copy your address link into the downgrader, or choose your main folder manually. I like the graphics, the old school, the charm. I get every time a nostalgic kick, especially in virtuality. I love to visit all games again in virtuality. It's like seeing something with your own eyes. It's a whole different story. And nowadays we have so many good virtuality games. I just don't need it to do it, but I'm angry about me that I did this not earlier. 2 years ago there was not much virtuality games. This would be perfect when I would spend my time with this 2 years ago. Anyway, it's never too late. Now copy my prepared mod archive into the folder, extract it, and you are ready to go. The Rockstar Launcher version will not downgrade. Just copy the downgrader into the main folder of your Rockstar Launcher San Andreas and copy my start file archive into the main folder. Of course, the San Andreas version from the Rockstar Launcher is not downgrading. See, it's not working. You get this message here. That's why you need my separate start file. Just extract it here and delete the other start file. The downgrader will create a new start file. You need two start files. Don't ask me why. All I know is that, for example, Thump, the multiplayer of San Andreas, needs the other start file. Yeah, and the multiplayer is also another story. You have a new start file. Now copy my prepared mod archive into the folder, extract it, and you are ready to go. But now we start on Andreas without WarpX and set some settings. This is for both versions the same. Go to settings, to mouse settings, and turn all to off, and turn the mouse sensitivity to high, to the highest point. Go to the advanced option and get sure that the widescreen is also off. We play with the 4:3 resolution and turn the frame limiter off. 4K 4:3. You can also set the anti-aliasing to the highest point. So now we go into first person and now press Alt and B and you get to this first person option menu. I recommend it 115 field of view and put the near clip to 6. You see here 4, but I will turn it later to 6 and you will understand why. There's also another option that I have to turn on. The rotate player with camera. That means that not just only the head is turning, the whole body is turning. Now let's go to the WarpX settings. Like I said, you have two start files. That's why I recommended to create another San Andreas profile with the other start file. Get sure you have choose the correct headset. When you use the SteamVR headset, choose SteamVR. When you use the Oculus headset, choose Oculus. Just press on create profile based on this profile. Keep the settings. Now you have a second profile and choose the other start file. That's important for multiplayer. for example, sample user, other start file. Okay, now it's important to make a custom resolution. In NVIDIA, you go just to your NVIDIA advanced settings, press on resolution, and just create a resolution like here in the video. So you really need a custom resolution. Without this resolution, you're playing like DK1, or you have a 4K monitor, and it's a different story. So this is the immersive screen, but there is no head tracking on the immersive screen. So set to full VR modus. Now we are setting the world scale. Go to first person. You see the red lines here on the ground? This is my boundary, my guardian, that I don't punch my wall or make accidents at home when I'm blind. So I use these lines to orientate to build the world scale in this game. The 3D string is the world scale. The world getting smaller when you turn 3D string high. So we have here not enough 3D string. That's why we go to near clip and set it to 6 now. And you get more 3D string by this near click option. Don't ask me why, but it's really true and it's helped me. It's helped to make it perfect. Now the red lines are under my ground. You can see it here on the flat screen monitor, but I see it in VR. My boundary lines are under the ground and my mouse is now on the slider. I look down and my mouse and it is at the same time on the 3D slider. Adjust my red lines to the ground. Let's come to the best option of WarpX, the option why I start liking WarpX. Yeah, room scale, head track positioning. Press on head track position unlock. Now you can go away and you have room scale and you see the first person and third person. Yeah. Now make the controller visible. That helps to set the wall scale even more perfect. Under controller settings. So I like it to make my controller visible. That helps me to orientate. I hold now my touch controller on the hand on CJ. You can probably do this with Vive 2 or other headset devices, but I'm already in trouble again. The world is dangerous in San Andreas. Spirit. So the world set is correct set. You see my boundary on the ground, my ground boundary. Also my controllers to orientate. I can go back and see if my hand is really in the area. Everything looks pretty good. And you have two recenter buttons. One for warp X. For me, I have to press Alt. You have to press Alt and space at the same time, probably. This is recentering for warp X. And you need sometimes also a recenter for some animations. When you jump in a vehicle. Did you see this? This world is alive. When you jump into a vehicle and after the animation, CJ looks forward. This is the same when I'm jumping. After the jump, CJ looks forward. When I, for example, look down and jump and look up again, you see everything is wrong. You can do two things now. I recommend it. Just look straight or stand straight like me. I'm standing. Look straight and just jump. Boom. And everything is fine again. Also looking back is helping. Yeah, it's on a middle mouse button and also on the numpad. This is also helping. Yeah. And when you jump in the vehicle, don't look down. Just look straight forward. At this moment, bam, and now your head is free and everything is fine. And you can actually look out of the window, the car window. So, and it's really important to have the correct angle. When you not have the correct angle, you hear much shit about Warpix. For example, let me do this again. I look down, jump, and now the head tracking is fucked. When you now try to look in the correct position and to look right and left, everything is fishy. Try really to hit the correct position. You can even look around and there's nothing fishy. But as soon as your head tracking position is a little bit wrong, only just a little bit, it's fishy. You need really to hit the correct head tracking position. It's not hard. You look just forward and jump, or you look just back for button. So I use the mouse just for turning. Yeah. You can find this option here. Warpix input settings, try pitch, turn this on. This is by default off, you can look up and down. But I can't recommend it to play like this. Sure, you can recenter every time. Maybe you like it, you can, sure you can play when you like it, like this. So when you hit a wrong head track position because of jumping, you can just look up and down with your mouse and correct it. But I like it, turn it off. No up and down for me with mouse. I have a new fresh version now. So you can really aim like a god here. It's not native VR, in native VR it's even better. And sure, you have no room scale, you can go out of the body. And this is just important for when you sit in a car, you want to look out of the window. The optimal would be a headless CJ. I have also a mod you can use, a headless CJ, but it's also in the cutscenes. Who is not playing San Andreas for the cutscenes? Only speedrunner and pros, but people like me that play this game not for 10 years or longer. It's like you're watching a good movie again. So this is for me really one of the, when not the best experience that I have with Warpix. And it works so great because you have no gun phase here, only when you aim. And that's why Warpix sucks for ego shooter. Many people make the mistake and use Warpix with ego shooter. Ego shooter is a bad idea because you have all the time a weapon in the face. You have all the time this here. And here you have a real body cam. It's amazing. So I play it really almost like the famous GTA 5 Loop Ross mod. There are also some problems. The cutscenes are very buggy sometimes. The person is walking but you have no free head cam. You are the cam and the cam is very sensitive. So I recommended here a FOV mod that you can turn the FOV higher for third person action. There's also a way I want to show you can recenter, right? And with this recenter you can play and adjust. For example, I go forward, press recenter, go back, and now I have also a perfect third person modus. And it's really comfortable to play like this for a moment. And you can, with this recenter of Warpix, correct the position easy peasy on motorcycle. Yeah, on the side seat you see this glitchy that's happened when you turn the FOV higher than 110, but you don't see it inside of the headset. And you can adjust the HUD how you want it. The editor is in the folder. And the resolution is good enough. You will see. The Holy Grail resolution. And you can even turn
this
it
X better.
I use the software already over 10 years now. Whenever I need a keyboard input on gamepad, I use this software. You have also a turbo button, toggle. Yeah, this software is excellent, superb, brilliant for everyone. So, and when you look my video, how to use the touch controller as gamepad, as direct input gamepad, or even X input gamepad, then you are able to use Kickspender like me. For you it's even more easy. You should just load the prepared files you can download here in my subscription. You will find the links. I will prepare everything. You have to put the picture, probably manual. I'm not sure what, but the picture is not necessary. So just press on 2 and you see everything prepared. On the right mouse, you see the key is also binded with 2. And 2 is Nitro in multiplayer. So whenever I press the right grip button, I get a complete free new layout. See, when I press grip button, I have different keys. That's helped me out because we have no D-pad. So, but this is keyboard keys. That's why you really need to change some settings. On keyboard you press W to accelerate the vehicle, and steering and accelerate on a thumbstick at the same time is a pain. That's why we have to change some controls. So San Andreas allows some double bindings. Go to vehicles. You can just use sprint for accelerate and jumping for brake. Also change, you see enter the vehicle. There's a enter input. You have really to delete the enter input because I have a double binding here. When you jump, it's also enter. It helps you when you're in menus. I use shift for accelerate and jumping for brake. You can do however you want it. And looking back is important to bind on number 1. This is the right thumbstick. It's in the game looking back